Live from a rapidly cooling part of Austin, the air is letting you know it's gonna be a great night. Now, hold on to your butts, butts holder. It's go time. Here are your hosts, Brian Brushwood and Justin Robert Young.
Hello, friends. My name is Justin Robert Young, and I want to let you guys know that my co-host on this program, Brian Brushwood, has been working on a project that's been near and dear to him for many, many years. And in the pursuit of that project, he has been up for about 46 of the last 48 hours.
What?
So,
oh, my God. Oh.
So... the show's going to be a little loose. It's going to be a little different. And so we are going to adjust to the Brian that we have. And we're going to celebrate the energy that he has to bring. And so I will not be on this show. At least in the A block.
Huh?
I will not be in the A block.
Wait.
Okay? Brian will be joined by my understudy, Captain Morgan. So I need Bryce and Brett. Just restart the show. Here we go.
All right. Brett, I will count you in.
Oh, shit. Hold on.
Okay.
Okay, do it again.
There we go. All right, everybody. Here we go. I'll count you in. In.
Live from a rapidly cooling part of Austin, the air is letting you know it's gonna be a great night. Now, really hold on to your butts, butts holders. It's go time. Here are your hosts, Brian Brushwood and Captain Morgan!
The guy who pretends to be the host, but secretly is floating on 2 hours of sleep over 3 days and had a disaster
How are you, Justin? What?
Justin Robert Young's not here.
What?
You're looking at your old pal. I'm here for you, Brian.
Oh, my God.
It's me, Captain Morgan. I'm not a bottle of rum.
You're a bottle of rum. This is happening again. You're a fucking bottle of rum, and I've known it the whole time.
Captain Henry James Morgan's a real historical figure, not intellectual property owned by Diageo Bottling.
You look an awful lot like a bottle of rum.
You look an awful lot like a piece of shit. It's that easy to win an argument. Just yell.
Actually,
it's a smart thing to do, Brian. I'm trying to teach you. Why don't you go ahead and talk?
I wanted to ask you, Captain Morgan, about the presidential debates.
Oh, yeah, sure. I like to watch them. I look at all of them and I say, hey, that's a bunch of faces. I'd like to put them on my wall and then throw paint. And then I'd sell the faces for money. And then I'd bring them to an art gallery and I'd say, hey, it's me, Captain Morgan. I'm selling faces for money. And they'd say, why? And I'd say, well, you know, I was watching the debates. I thought it'd be a cool thing. What are you, some piece of shit who runs an art gallery? You trust fund dick? And then they'd say, whoa, what are you yelling at me? And I'd say, whoa, never mind, I'm Hunter Biden. And then they'd give me $1 million.
Well, I was wondering, because I'm not sure who to vote for. We all know
that I'm here to tell you, Brian. I'm here for you, after all.
We all know that you can either vote for a skeleton or a fat skeleton.
Sure. That's the only two options you get. You can go to the bowling booth and you say, hey, give me my ballot. And they say, sure. And then they just say, put out your hands. And you say, what? This isn't Dominion. And then they say, this is the new way. And then they put a fat skeleton in your left and a small skeleton in your right. And then they say, which one feels like Christ? And then you say, oh, I don't know. The one that I looked at before. But they say, you can't look. And I say, okay.
Okay, but what if that system gets hacked?
Well, I was at DEF CON, Brian. And they said it can be hacked.
Oh.
Because when you're not looking, they won't put a fat skeleton in. They'll put a pine cone. And then when it won't be a skinny skeleton, it'll be a small dead lizard.
So,
which I guess is a skeleton when you think about it. These hackers have thought of everything.
I've heard that there is a bunch of... I suspect that our current president...
Yes.
Joseph,
who is...
Joseph Robinette Biden Jr.
Biden Jerry.
Yep.
Yes.
Yep. Okay. I've heard that he...
That's what they used to call Germans.
Very, very likely...
Jerry's.
Very, very likely.
Hey, Jerry, why don't you eat some more bratwurst? That's what I'd say to him. Hey, get out of here with your lederhosen. Huh? The fuck? What do you think you're doing? You're short shorts, you're wearing coochie cutters with suspenders and acting like you fucking own the place.
I
call Lenny Riefenstahl to shoot that fucking homemade porn.
Jesus.
I am under the... I'm assuming that he will be
I'm
the Democratic...
For you.
I am assuming that he will be the Democratic candidate.
Yes.
But meanwhile...
Me too.
What?
And maybe him.
I was about... What,
he's very old.
Should I hashtag that or...
Hashtag it.
Yeah.
Hash it. Boom.
Okay. What you said?
Yep.
I was trying to make a Me Too joke.
I'm here for you.
Okay, so there's the, I don't know, some weird, the Rockettes of Republicans. Which one, can we run through some of them and talk about them?
Mm-hmm. Asia Hutchman. he's a guy.
Asia Hutchman.
Asia Hutchman. He's a man who's more hutch than man. He's got a lot of curios in his chest.
I don't know.
And if you ask him nicely, he'll pull out a small shot glass that your grandma bought when she was 10.
Captain Morgan, are you using a pseudonym for Vivek Ramaswamy?
No, it was for Asia Hutchinson. I was literally working my way from the end of the stage to the middle. But you want to know what? Fuck it. Let's go to the Indian guy.
The only person who talks about race more than Bryce is me.
Yeah, no. I love race. Race is great.
This is not good out of context.
No, Bryce. I was talking to Bryce the other day, and he said, I've got a big power ranking for the races.
I love... Well, for the...
Yeah.
The racing event.
I love it. I love that some races are really messy and they're fucked up always. And it's almost like they were born that way.
Yeah, sorry, Monaco.
And then other races are beautiful and perfect and mathematically superior.
One moment, Captain Morgan.
Yes.
Bryce, do you happen to remember which album it was that we did a track about? Like, I drive cars. I race. I'm a racist.
Sure.
In fact, I'm the best racist in the planet. The joke being that the words in the thing.
That race thing is the same as being a racist,
Captain.
That was from Night Attack 2, Enjoy the Garden. I believe that was racist, Justin.
Wait, no. Captain Morgan was on that. You were on that album, right?
I don't fucking remember. What do you think I am, the custodian of my own life?
He was on.
No, I don't know. I don't know what goes on. I remember one
hold
time.
Hold on.
I was, okay.
Captain Morgan. Captain Morgan.
Yes.
I am sensing
I'm here for you.
A little bit of defensiveness.
No.
I mean, I know there was a lot of sessions and you were there for the Night Attack 2 recording sessions.
Yes.
But your parts, where did those end up?
Well, number one, I showed up to you in a vision. I was there. I appeared to you and I said, Brian, I'm here for you. I'm here to answer all your questions.
No. It was truly one of the most...
And then that racist piece of shit, Justin Robert Young, cut me out of the goddamn album.
Oh, my God. You got beef with Justin?
Yes.
He's my co-host.
No, fuck him. He's fucking... There's a lot of words that Captain Morgan wanted to say that he's being uncharacteristically circumspect about.
Sam!
No!
Come on, Sam!
Better. This is growth. Anyways.
safe to say
that I don't like him. Yeah. I think he's a real snake in the grass is what I'm saying. He's a real piece of garbage. Anyway, my name is Captain Morgan, and I was supposed to be on the album, and then all of a sudden, I was only on the promo. And then everybody was like, oh my God, the promo is so good. We'll make puppet videos about the promo. And then the album came out, and everybody said, where's more Captain? And I said, hey, if you got a fucking problem with it, then why don't you fucking call Justin? Here's his number, 954.
Hold on one second. And of course, eventually your segments became animated. How did that feel? Because they did show up on the show.
They became a big part of the show, Brian. And I was there, and Spearmint Nitrate made cartoons, and that was good. What I really want to know, though, is what happened at lunch 2 days ago? I'm here for you, Brian.
God damn it. I just realized what you did.
I want to know.
I have a first topic.
Yes.
A secret test.
All right, Captain Morgan.
It's a secret test. You'd never know. Because no one would tell you.
You want to do the other one?
Yep.
Okay.
Do the other one.
Nice.
Remind me of this great intro improv, though.
Happy birthday.
This intro improv was, it was going to be fire. The happy birthday of what the fuck? What the fuck? Okay. I'm asking.
Okay. So yesterday.
Yes.
Or today, as far as my fog.
You've been awake for a long time, bro.
You know what?
It's only when you're up for 48 hours that I appear.
is that how I summon?
That's how it happens, Brian. Okay. Okay. I'm here for you. Yeah, whenever things are getting dangerously off the rails, I'm like Clarence the Angel. Although you're not trying to kill yourself, I don't think. But you still have George Bailey's heart. You ripped it out of his chest like a warrior.
That was
fuck
cool.
Him and fuck that town too.
Potterville?
Yeah.
Wait a minute. You're sort of a supernatural creation.
I don't know. Maybe.
So in the future, they sort of depict in It's a Wonderful Life.
Sure.
Basically the beginnings of a Las Vegas, right?
I don't know. I don't usually watch it.
Well,
normally I just skip to the end. Well, actually, no, I skip to the middle and I say, well, that's the happy ending to me. I'm a morose man, Brian. I don't give a shit. I have a chaotic energy.
You're like
I'm chaotic neutral.
You're like, where's the end of act two? I want to see everybody at their lowest.
That's
okay.
Me. Bailey's a simp. George Bailey would be an NPC TikTok streamer.
Captain Morgan, do you want to make
a donation so good?
Do you want to make a fuck ton of money?
Yes, I do, Brian. Finally, we're going to make some Skrilla.
I believe.
Let's clean up. Let's make this bankroll.
I'm throwing
money everywhere. That's what I want to do.
Okay.
All I see is dollar signs. All I see is dollar signs. Whoa, money on my mind, money on my mind.
Okay, so I have a pitch for you.
Riri's my bitch. Go ahead.
I'm not entirely sure, and maybe Bryce can research.
Yeah.
But
what does this have to do with your lunch?
There's copyright law that says that things expire 70 years after the creator dies. I wonder what the status of It's a Wonderful Life is. Basically, what if we did...
Eat it, Capra.
We did a hard-nosed, I don't know, noir detective story or something, or some kind of HBO Soprano shit or whatever.
Yep.
But it was Potterville.
Yes. A gritty reboot of Potterville. Although I like the fact that it would be The Sopranos, because I'd like to keep it the same script, but every scene, every character is eating gabagool.
Gabagool.
That's what I would do. Hey, look, no bad ideas in a brainstorm, right?
I don't know.
I just wanted lunch meat.
I'm sorry.
That's really what I wanted.
I don't know what...
I'm Capra Morgan, Brian.
No, you're a bottle of rum.
Not a bottle of rum. No. Tell me what happened to fucking lunch, you piece of shit. You piece of fucking shit. Tell me what happened to lunch. You keep promising me with just...
I want lunch.
I want lunch.
We had a funny idea.
Give me names.
So for a moment, unfortunately, it gets a little bit silly. That's the funny part.
Oh, I don't like that. Give me the serious version. Just kidding. I'm drunk.
Okay. All right. Captain Morgan,
yes.
I'm going to need you to actually do...
Okay.
Now, I know you're Captain Morgan, but I'm going to need you
mm-hmm.
to do your best genuine impression of Justin Robert Young.
Okay.
Because in the character diamond, there's only so many wild cards you can have. And I know you're a little bit out there.
I'm not. I'm a part of you. I'm a part of you.
Now, I know you hate Justin Robert.
This song that I'm singing is gotta be true, because I'm a part of you. Captain Morgan is blue. He is a part of the Crips, and that is definitely true. Sorry. I feel the flow. I just go with it. So anyway, I'll do an impression of that cock, Justin. Go.
Okay. But I need you to sell it because
I'm selling it like I was on the streets. Selling this puss. That's what I do.
Wait.
I'm selling it. This puss.
It's a metaphor,
Brian.
Oh, okay. Right.
Yeah. I was hooking. Street walking.
okay.
Flipping this cheeks like I was at the McDonald's.
Flipping them?
Flipping them. Flipping them and ripping them.
What?
Yep.
Ripping them.
Oh, my heart. Top dollar.
Explain everything you just said.
Well, so I said, Brian, that I was hooking. And then I said it was a metaphor. Being a hooker, so I said that was a metaphor, so I don't know what I meant. I don't know. That's up to the audience.
Right.
Brian.
Yes.
Theater of the mind.
Okay.
What happened at lunch?
Our good friend, Mike TV,
I love him. He might be Jesus.
Justin.
Yes. Oh wait!
See, that's the problem, Captain. I asked you, you want me to pretend to be Justin? Yes, that's literally
okay,
the
on,
word.
Hold on! Shut up! Hold on! I'll do it. Okay. Here we go.
All right.
Excuse me, it's me. Justin Robert Young.
Thank you, Justin. I'm glad you are here on a perfectly normal episode.
Yep.
So, Bryce, Mike TV reached out and said, hey, you want to have lunch? And I knew for very chaotic reasons over the last 2 weeks that I also owed some time with Bonnie. And so it ended up being me and Mike TV and Bonnie.
Okay.
At our favorite hangout. And oh my goodness. By the way, ladies and gentlemen, if there's nothing better on the planet than knowing that you can write off $200 on a bar tab and call it a writer's meeting. It was very...
Excelsior! What happened at lunch?
All right, hold on. One second. Cap Morgan.
Wait, you talking want to me Justin. Or the character that I'm playing?
I have no idea. You know what? Actually, that's great, Justin Robert Young.
Hooray! I'm a virgin. So you got that classic thumbs up, that classic virgin thumbs up.
So anyway, Justin Robert Young, the three of us were hanging around and Bonnie brought up, the idea of, the fact that, Josie is obsessed with like, freestyle rap battles and all that stuff. She's currently in a, kind of a garage rock band. And, at some point,
she's not in some kind of crew.
No,
where
Justin.
She would be battling.
Well, that's the thing is we were talking about at some point my daughter said, I would like to make the happy birthday of freestyle rap diss tracks. Yeah, you know, happy birthday, right?
Happy birthday to you.
Thank you, Justin Robert
you
Young.
You live in a zoo.
Yes, thank you.
You're some kind of animal, and we should shoot you.
Okay. The one thing you left out is that the reason happy birthday to you works is because there's a pause where everyone gets to insert the name of whoever's birthday it is.
Indubitably.
So imagine an epic rap battle freestyle that was a happy birthday thing that became universal, where everybody knew it, and then they could dunk on somebody else. That was Josie's idea, our 15-year-old. And because I'm a terrible person, I took that idea and I stole it from my own child. Mm. And I
made a topic on a show about it.
No, I did much more. I went to my BFF, Chatty G. That's what I'm calling Chat GPT. And by the way, I'm totally gonna make that a thing because saying Chat GPT is fucking bullshit. Call her Chatter G.
This is how you make nicknames stay sick. Is you explain them,
declaring them. You well in
Chatty G.
Chatty G.
Hey, watch your corner, dickhead.
My best friend, Chatty G, had, I asked, like, the idea came up, like, what else could be a happy birthday of? And suggest genres or whatever. And my BFF, Chatty G, said, what about the happy birthday of funeral dirges? Or the happy birthday of Thanksgiving Day parades? Or those things. But the one that tickled us the most was the happy birthday of epic high intensity fitness, basically Orange Theory anthems.
Well, I'll be.
And we began to have a discussion about what that would sound like and what would it...
So if you were to describe a Orange Theory style anthem, what kind of song would that be, Brian?
It would be a very specific beat rhythm that kind of matched up, give or take, what, you know, your jogging or running is on that stuff. It would probably have a bunch of riffs that maybe you've heard before, but mainly it would be encouraging you to get in the zone. And so we thought, what if there was a website, and this never ended up happening, but we were talking about what would it be
How
like.
How long ago did it happen?
24 hours, my friend.
I don't think that's even true.
48 hours, my
there
friend.
There we go.
Okay, good. Oh, Justin.
Oh, me.
So
I've never smelled pussy. It's me. Justin Robert Young.
Is that second base?
I don't know.
Yeah. Good sell. Okay.
This is my new favorite character.
You mean your favorite co-host of your show that you've been
yep, yep. It's just a normal show we always do. I'm not an impression by Captain Morgan.
So the idea was, okay, there are, let's say 10% of America, that's what, 30 million people who are doing fitness every day, and there's maybe one for three for the whatever. There's 1 million.
There's a lot of people working out.
And then we had the idea for a website where you would go and you would generate a personalized license plate to end your set list. So the idea is you would work out very hard for 45 minutes, and then at the end there would be this this thing where it's like it would basically be a joke where we would set up the setup, and then all they had to do was download the punchline. So imagine you're going.
Sounds easy to follow.
No. What, okay, wait, Justin. You do Orange Theory, right?
Indeed.
Okay.
I love it. I love being surrounded by a bunch of suburban moms. That's how I feel powerful.
Okay, so you've been there for like the nearing the end threshold where it's like there's this rhythm and you're going and you're going, and then it's like, and now really go for it. You've been there for that.
Indeed. That's a thing I've done a lot.
So the idea was...
I think about it right now. I want to do it more.
The idea... is by the way, Captain Morgan.
Thank
Morgan,
fucking God, Jesus.
Number one.
Who wants to deal with that cuck?
Me. Like, you are really good at impressions.
Right. Well, you know, I've got a lot of skills, Brian. You want to know a couple other skills I got?
Yeah. Like what?
Rapier fencing.
Oof. That took a hard left.
Yep. On guard. On touche. That's what I would say to you if I were fencing with a rapier.
Yeah.
That wouldn't be that. I would just say that to let you know that I'm also a cowboy. On a steel horse I ride, Brian. And I'm wanted. Dead or alive. That's something I just came up with. Off the top of the dome. I'm freestyling now. I should be in a freestyle crew.
Okay, so
the five members of hip hop, there would be a freestyle. No, wait, hold on. graffiti, DJs, MCs, international bankers. And refrigerator repairmen. Those are the five members of hip hop. 50 years okay. young. 50 years young, hip hop.
All right.
Anyway, go on with your story.
Captain Morgan, you know that Justin Robert Young just evaporated, right?
Yeah, he's dead.
Yeah,
he's gone away. You want him to come back?
No, I don't. I
fuck him. Jesus, but, I'm so glad they do not make me do the impression.
You heard the whole setup for the joke.
Of course,
right?
I did. Yes. Yeah, so you're doing a thing, and you want to set up a website where somebody would be able to make a song that would be played at the very, very end of their high intensity interval training workout that would have an element of a personalized thing at the end, in the same way that Happy Birthday allows everybody to yell that person's name in a heightened moment where they're gonna appreciate it the most.
I have wonderful news for you, Captain Morgan.
Okay.
Within 48 hours, Mike TV has already produced the core track that will make up that website.
You're cutting me.
I'm sorry, what?
Move on.
The part that we thought was funniest was a whole workout and then have the, I don't know, the ringmaster. Is that what they call them?
Yep.
I love you,
he gets appointed by the.
I love you,
he gets appointed by the president. He's like the head of the CIA. the attorney general, and then the ringmaster.
Wait.
And then the ringmaster's like, wait a minute, am I at a fucking circus? What am I going to do, whipping a lion into the eye? And President Biden says, just kidding. He says, hey, no, you're the ringmaster. You're going to make all the ringtones real. And then they'll say, wait a minute, I didn't think this was still a job. And then Biden will say, we'll give you the number of somebody who did it before. And then he calls him up on the phone, and he hears over the static, ming, 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 ming,
ming.
Five people got it, but they're fucking dying. They're fucking falling on the floor laughing.
You're stealing my audience. You're playing to your own base.
No, I'm. I don't know. I don't know what's going on. I'm a part of you, Brian. I'm in your head. We're the same person. Well, this is like a lot like when you're like Eddie Brock and I'm the symbiote.
There you go.
We are Venom. Together.
Oh, got it. Yeah. I'm a shit reporter, and you're a weirdo.
Okay. Checks out.
I just realized that I said those words, and you actually got a degree in journalism.
I don't give a no. No, I didn't get it. Hey, fuck you. I mean, I did get a degree in journalism.
Oh, you did.
It was in 1804. I was a man of letters, and I went to another place where letters were honored, and I said, hey, ABCD, and they said, do you want a degree in journalism? And I said, how much? And they said, $4. Inflation wasn't so big back then. And I said, okay. So I got a degree in journalism, and then I
Wait. Captain Morgan, I'm into this, but I gotta pull you back for the landing of this bit.
Efficient as always.
That's why you're the captain.
I love you. I'm here for you.
So we ended up finding whatever. We think it's a funny idea that if there was a website, and the challenge I left with Mike TV was to make a version of what the track would sound like that would be like autocomplete generated or whatever. Like you just type in the name that's customized, and it would be intentionally shitty. Because Captain Morgan, you've seen the mugs and the little license plates and all that shit.
Yeah.
What mugs?
Wait, the mugs and the license plates. The fuck are you talking about? Wait, I mean, you mean like at like a tchotchke shop?
Or yes.
So if you're like at a, you know, you're at the Matterhorn or something like that, and you drive by and you're like, oh, my name is Doug, and then there's Doug on a Matterhorn license plate. Okay,
yes.
All right, I got you now.
So what if there was
I grok you in fullness, Brian.
what if there was a website where you could just type the name and a robot would say the voice, and it would make a complete track to encourage
you
one
to
person
keep running.
You to assure you that you could do it.
Exactly.
And Mike TV sent us up. Bryce, do we have it? I don't know if you sent it yet. Oh,
yes.
We do? Okay. So Mike TV the next day sent us the track. And now,
oh, my God. So wait, you had this idea.
Yep.
And then 24 hours later, that piece
Mike
of
TV.
Shit slacker, Mike TV, who's written one song in the last 8 years, all of a sudden wrote a song just for you?
He actually made five albums and then did the following.
I know. He's just a guy, isn't he? He's just doing so many things at Mike TV.
Theater of the mind. I want you
theater,
to make sure you're working out.
All right, hold on. It's me. I'm Captain Morgan, and I'm on a treadmill.
There you are.
Oh, no. Am I in the blue zone? Am I in the green zone? Oh, I've gotten into the orange zone. I'm Captain Morgan.
Splat.
I've gotten a splat. Oh, Jesus Christ. I haven't run this fast since
splat.
I fucked the Pope's brother.
And then
expected more of a reaction from that. But that's what happens when physical fitness. You can't rely on the results. You gotta trust the process. Here we go. We're going. Oh Jesus! Oh wait, hold on. Is there a song that's playing?
All right, it's me, your ringmaster. Sandy.
I voted for Sandy. I'm so excited that Sandy, that him or her got appointed.
Listen up, you guys have done so good. I think you're right on the very, very edge.
I'm about to red.
What?
Red, you on the edge. Go, move. Okay. I'm running.
Okay, listen.
Go.
We have a lot of people here, including Carl.
Yep.
And we just want to encourage everyone.
And me, the captain.
Well, I guess you're here. All right.
Yes. I'm Captain Morgan. I'm a real historical figure, by the way. Look me up on Wikipedia.
But anyway,
the first governor of Jamaica.
Let's really give a push at the end of our intense HIIT workout.
Yep.
With this very special track.
Oh my fucking God!
You can do it, struggle through it, nothing to it, you can do it, oh yes you can. Push on through it, do it to it, pilot through it, nothing to it, oh yes you can. We can be the things we wanna be, oh yes we can, oh yes we can, oh you and me. Do it, you can do it. Push on through it. You can do it like you know you can, Carl.
You can oh my God.
My birth name is Carl.
Oh, keep going. Again.
You will make it. Don't need to fake it. Just need to take it. Then we'll make it like it's never been. We can be the things we want to be. Oh, yes, we can. We can. Oh, yes, we can. Oh, you and me can make it. No one can take it. It's all you got. And it is all that you will ever need, Carl.
Oh, Jesus, I'm running even faster now!
I think that's a funny bit.
So do I, Brian.
You can tell from the big applause that I got when it ended.
Life's a journey, not a destination, Brian, you know. You know, that's the thing.
It's not a theory, it's science.
No. Hey. Why are you doing that?
Why
are you looking so cross-eyed? What are you, some kind of weird... You want to be a cyclops, putting your two eyes together into one? Making yourself a one-eyed man? Don't do it. A friend of mine did it. His name was the Cyclops. And boy, did he fucking regret it. He tried to cross his eyes so hard he made a one eye, and now it's like, hey, Cyclops, knock it the fuck off. And he was like, I want a water one. I was like, well, all right. And then he did it, and everyone made fun of him. And I was like, hey, guess what, dipshit? You fucking deserve it, asshole. And then I left. I moved to Minneapolis. I was the man who brought a little apple there, and they said, hey, we're going to call ourselves the little apple. And I was like, well, fuck, I don't know, man. This is my bit. I have a tiny apple. And then they were like, we're going to name the whole city after that. And I'm like, well, fucking whatever.
It's a funny idea, though, right?
It is a good idea.
Yeah, I don't know. I feel like
I'm gonna steal it.
And I also feel like your bottle of rum. And I also feel like everybody should go to Patreon.
Where? Hold on. You had another topic.
I mean,
oh no, we're here.
Oh, for real?
Oh, we're going.
You said this. This is your episode today, Brian. This is.
I feel like this. We're cooking with gas, Brian. Well, I feel like we're here now. Look, we've built a perfect mousetrap. It doesn't matter how many of these vermin we're snapping all their necks.
What's
the next? Bryce's next number.
A secret test.
Ah, shit. This test is so secret. Shut up.
So, Captain,
I'm here for you.
Have you ever? Yeah, you have a long and storied career.
I do. One time, I. Me and Princess Diana were rum running.
The paparazzi showed up.
Oh, the paparazzi came going up on our starboard bow. And I said to you, I said, well, hey, look, I'm going to show just the left side of my asshole and we'll see if it can blind their cameras. And Diana's, I called her Di. And she was, I was like, Di, you think that'll work? And she said, I don't know. I'm fucked up, dude. I'm fucked up on poppers. And I'm like, why? And she's like, shut up. I'm trying to pass the SATs. That's what I think she said. She might have said something else. So I flashed half my asshole to the paparazzi on my starboard bow. And the paparazzi were like, gross. So they left. And then we went to a island destination and played Bocceezy.
Right. But
sorry, there wasn't really a big finish. It was mostly about half my asshole.
Among all of the jobs you've done, have you ever been a magician?
Yeah. One time I had a trip to the Orient.
To where?
The Orient, Brian. It's okay to call a place the Orient. It's not okay to call anything else.
That's the thing that you're comfortable saying right now.
Brian, look, I'm also here for an updated list of cultural norms, Brian. Okay. I've lived for a long time. And so anyway, on my way to the Orient, I will learn about a different magic. And so I would like to perform this magic trick for you.
Wait, oh my God.
Hold on.
Hold on. Am I hearing this right?
Yeah, I'm going to do a little
magic. For the first time
trick.
Ever, you, Captain Morgan, a historical figure who is unaffiliated with any liquor brands, is about to perform a magic trick for me.
Not intellectual robbery from Diageo, but I'll tell you that fucking much. Real person, Captain Henry James Morgan.
I would love nothing more.
Okay. All right, here we go. This is a trick I was taught by an old man called Only for Audio Listeners.
Oh, wow.
That's an odd name.
Oh, wow.
I can't believe what I'm seeing. Bryce, you're seeing this, right?
I can't believe
this. It's on the video version.
Now, in my 15 years of videos.
Hold on. Shut the fuck up, Bryce. Brian, I need you to pick one.
Pick one, I guess. Oh, there's
which
so many.
One? Just point at one.
There it is.
Thank you.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, there it goes.
Oh, you're welcome, video watchers.
How did what?
No, it was only for audio watchers.
Is the name of the bit?
Yep. Yeah.
Yeah.
Was this your one?
Oh, got it. What? Oh, God damn it. Cap Morgan, that was adorable.
Brian, are you fooled or are you not fooled?
I'm not fooled.
Hey! God damn it, I love you all.
Anyway, what happened at lunch?
Captain Morgan, We're on to a tale where Brian becomes the wild card, so maybe we should save this magic trick for next week.
No, we're here now.
I mean, Bryce does have a game ready to go.
We're here now.
No, I'm here with you.
Oh, okay.
Why don't you trust me? Do you think that I'm...
Because you're a bottle of rum. No, you're not even a real person.
I'm not a bottle of rum. Brian.
Wait, look,
this is the part of the movie. This is the part of the movie.
Shut up, promo
dickhead.
Material.
This is the part of the movie where you realize that I'm here to help you. I'm not your antagonist. I'm just the second banana. I'm the other guy to you. I'm like the... other dude next to the famous guy. I'm like the person who's on the side of the other man who's does good. Anyway, so here we go.
Okay, look.
Do your magic trick, and I'll be with you the entire time. It's going to be better for me being here. Just telling you.
Okay, this magic trick is extraordinary.
Big time.
But it's only going to work if I'm the one who goes crazy. It's fine.
I'm by normal, Captain. Anyway, Brian, go ahead. And now, direct from his trip from the Orient, it's Brian Brushwood.
Captain Morgan, you're familiar with the Beatles, right?
Fuck yeah.
You know the Paul McCartney?
I know Paul. He's a great guy.
Yes. And you know he makes a lot out of a little, right?
Oh, he makes a chicken salad out of chicken shit. This guy is an amazing man.
It's very tempting. but I found out recently that he made and starting now, nothing I say is going to be a lie.
Absolute truth.
There'll be one thing that'll be my opinion.
Yep.
He made what, in my opinion, is the world's greatest book test.
What the fuck? You're telling me that Paul McCartney of the fucking Beatles made the world's greatest book test a magic trick? That's fucking insane.
You're familiar with the book test, right?
Test is what happens when you go and a magician gives you a bunch of books to go pick from, and you pick one book, and then you go into the book, and you go wherever the you want to. You do whatever you want, and then all of a sudden the magician, this sneaky fucker, tells you exactly where you are in the book because they know. So wait, hold on. You're telling me the Paul McCartney. From the Beatles.
Yep.
From Wings.
Well,
and from the Beatles. That he made a great book test. Wait, I didn't even know he fucking wrote books.
Okay, so here's the crazy part.
What?
He made it 35 years ago, and this motherfucker was so committed to the bit, he created a fake band that doesn't exist. He bothered after releasing it to camouflage it with a whole bunch of fucking other albums. They pretended that the band was real after that. And get this, back when he had the idea, he recruited Brian Eno. Do you know Brian Eno,
a music legend himself and one of the pioneers of ambient music.
Yes. And so in my opinion, I have to assume that Paul McCartney wanted to create the best fucking magic gift on the planet, because guess how many dollars it costs? Zero.
Well, hold on. Wait a minute. You know that the captain has his mind on his money and his money on his mind. Okay. So when you say that this costs $0.
Yes.
What do you mean?
What I mean is Paul McCartney, and this is at this point my fantasy, Paul McCartney woke up one day, and I assume he went, I don't like magic. What do I should do? I should head on over and create the world's greatest book test. It's a type of magic. Theatrical magic chess. And then, you know what I should do? Let's make sure real good. Sandra! Who's the guy that did the YouTube? I should walk on over to Brian Eno's place. And so, and he did.
Hold on.
What?
Brian, I'm here to tell you something.
Yes.
Paul McCartney did say that. Word for word. And I know because I was there.
Oh my God.
Me and Paul McCartney were taking shots of Rumplemints out of old shoes.
Oh my God.
And we both fell asleep and he woke up and that was the first thing that fucker said. Now I don't know what happened after that because I went to McDonald's.
Wait,
I assume that, yes, I will tell you for a fact that fucking happened. Tell me what else.
Okay, so what I've always assumed is Paul McCartney said, let me create the world's greatest book test and let me do a genre-breaking variation on it where it's not even a book. It's an incredible experience that you could do via audio, but over the phone, over the radio. Like doing magic over the radio was very, very difficult. Doing
something impossible.
Exactly, right? Oh, my God, I would love to know what he was thinking at the time. Here's the important thing,
Brian, I can tell you what he was thinking.
Yes.
Two things.
Yeah.
Number one.
Yes.
I'd like to jerk off. Number two, I should really finish this magic trick. And so you believe he did.
I do believe he did. Oh, you're a rascal. but at this point, he has this idea, and in my imagination, he goes and he visits Brian Eno, and he's like, I have an idea for the world's greatest magic. If only 50 years from now, or
35.
Let's go with that.
40 years from now, somebody would do it on a podcast. It's fucking awesome. And Brian Eno is like,
oh, okay. Here, I'll do my. I know him well.
Because you were there.
Well, he's like my. He's my second favorite, Brian. Anyway, so Brian Eno sounds. Well, do your impression of Paul McCartney.
Brian Eno, I have an idea for. Is a genre bending book test? It's a magic trick where anyone can select anything and you figured it out.
Okay, hold on. Here's my Brian Eno.
Sorry, did you say...
No, right? No, here we go. Hold on.
Yes.
I'm Brian Eno. I like fucking pussy all the time. I'm Mr. Pussy Fucker Brian Eno. Hey, thank you, Paul McCartney from the Beatles. You came out here. I'll help you with a thing. I make a bunch of music. I'm Brian Eno.
Well, I mean, you were there, so I'm going to assume that's how it sounded.
Oh, God, no. We have a lot of people tell us we sound alike.
The craziest part.
What?
Is that, you know what? Would you like to try the magic trick right
Holy
now?
Holy shit, yes.
This is a real magic trick.
I didn't know that he was working on this the entire time, but you're telling me that there's
no,
a magic trick.
He already delivered
it. It's done.
No.
I was saying back in the day, but here we go. All right, hold on. Why don't we have Bryce, that useless piece of shit. Hey.
Okay.
I just like saying hey.
So, Bryce.
Yes.
Paul McCartney created a fake band called The Fireman. Now you would think that would be like two words or whatever, but they mesh. So it's like The Fireman.
Yeah.
That's what it looks like. But everybody.
Kind of like The Liar Man.
Everybody.
Clap
listening.
Your hands. Clap, clap. No, anyway, go ahead.
By the way, every single thing I have said so far is 100%.
No, this is absolutely true.
We're still in
Look,
the truth,
I know,
zone.
Yes, obviously,
Theater
there's
of the
a
mind.
Lot of heightened characters,
okay,
but for the integrity of this trick, you need to understand that everything that's been said is true. And by the way, if you want to fucking, if you challenge me,
pause.
If you're doubting me, you piece of fucking garbage, listening to me right now, I want you to go on your Spotify, go on your Apple Music, and I want you to look up The Fireman.
In fact, we'll have Bryce do it right now.
Yes. Well, no, go, no. To the doubting Thomas piece of shit at home who thinks that this is a bit because Captain Morgan's involved, then fucking do it yourself. We didn't put that shit on there. Look up where the publishing is, you fucking rat bastard. Go fucking do it.
Like, he was so committed. He did a Wired magazine article where he was doing a shh, and there was a headline that said, Paul McCartney is secretly releasing a techno album. And at the time, I it was 1994, I think, and I was just getting into techno, and I love the Beatles. And so at the time, I did not know he was making a fucking magic trick. It was incredible. So at this point, so then they made multiple albums after that, but those were all fake. The real one is the first one. So, Bryce, what are the titles of the albums that you see?
Sure. I see three albums here. I see 2008's Electric Argument. I see 1998's Rushes.
Camouflage.
And 1993's Starberries, Oceans, Ships, Forest.
That is the secret magic trick book test that Paul McCartney created.
You wanted to go ahead and put that finger on that button, Bryce, and select that album.
Go ahead and select that album. And you know what? I'm going to perform it.
Go ahead.
Bryce, you've got the album.
Yeah.
Here's what I want you to do. Open it up in Spotify, YouTube, any fucking app you want. And what I want you to do is select a track. It's important that you not tell me the track because this has to be a free choice or otherwise it doesn't work per the rules of Paul McCartney.
Okay, I have picked a track. I have selected it. I've confirmed it. And I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Okay, so here's the hard part is I need you to kind of start to play it, but just scrub up and down on the Spotify so that make sure that I don't hear anything because otherwise, and at this point, we're entering Theater of the Mind. There's a sealed envelope above. Are you able to scrub without me hearing it?
Yes, I'm scrubbing right now. I'm getting all of the dirt out of it.
Okay. Awesome. So, you got a track, you got a place, you're able to hit play and hear it, right?
Yes.
Okay. Let's take a moment. Let's remember. Whatever. Skip to this part.
Good call.
We're going to do a trust fall. I want you to see, audio listeners, holding this envelope. And by the way, this is the moment for everybody at home. Do all of your research and find one fucking lie outside of the fact that this is a book test. And now, Bryce?
Yes.
I'm going to open up my sealed envelope.
Okay.
It's a metaphorical envelope.
Pull it out.
Yep.
You see it, Captain Morgan?
Indeed I do, Brian.
I'm going to read it for everyone.
Go ahead.
It's dated today and right now, and it says, bop, 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 woo. Bop, 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 woo. Bop, 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 woo.
Wait, hold on. You're telling me in the entire goddamn album of techno music.
No, I'm not saying
that the moment that he picked is bop ba da bop 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 woo bop ba da bop 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 woo.
Yes.
Bop ba da bop 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 woo.
Yes.
You're telling me he could have picked anything.
Yes.
And the moment that he picked is bop ba da bop 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 woo.
Yeah.
Bop ba da bop 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 woo.
Yes.
Bop ba da bop 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 woo. That'd be fucking impossible, Brian. I was with Paul McCartney. I was with Brian Eno. They made a bunch of music. He's a musical fucking genius. You would have to be a goddamn psychic if you knew where that man put his finger.
You know what? Let's let Bryce solve this conundrum. Bryce, which track did you pick? Which number? What was the name of it?
Yes, I picked track number 2, Translunar Rising. Let's take a listen.
Let's not get political.
Whoa.
Oh.
What time code did you end up at?
I am at 6 minutes, 21 seconds.
All right, real quick, everybody in the room.
Long one.
What was the prediction? What was in the envelope?
Bop, 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 woo! Bop, 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 bop,
excellent. Woo! All right, Bryce?
Yes.
Press play.
All right, here we go.
Here it comes. Feel it, right? Bop,
bop, bop, bop, bop, bop, woo! Doing it.
Holy shit.
This motherfucker, my most respected Beatle. What the fuck, Paul McCartney? You made a fucking single about somebody ringing a goddamn doorbell. You had this idea for an album. You walked over to Brian Eno and you said, hey, would you like to jerk off in front of everybody? And he said, what did he say?
Bop, 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 bop. Woo!
Oh, no. That was Paul's job.
What?
Brian Eno was like, I'm fucking Brian Eno. My fist smells like poon. And I'm waving them around. They call me old poon hands, Brian Eno.
And then meanwhile, Paul McCartney, this motherfucker who just, he releases a fucking masterclass about music and quite literally, one of my fucking heroes says, well, I don't really see where the problem is. You walk up to a
to a fucking piano, you just go a blink, blink, a blong, a blink, blink, a blong, and you get another one hit. And this asshole walks into a studio with Brian Eno for 3 seconds and says, well, let's get started. A bop, bop, up, bop, 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 woo. And then Brian Eno releases not just a single, but 9 singles, and they release it under a fake name. Bryce, let's try the trick again. Literally fucking pick anywhere. I don't know what the fuck this thing is, but I know for sure that I understand that they refuse to release it under their own name.
All right, this is from the middle of a track, a later track, Sunrise Mix.
Beautiful.
All right. Now there are some of you guys who might think.
Okay. Yeah.
Oh, sorry. Did I cut something off?
Oh no.
No, Brian. Please,
I'm just shocked.
Pick somewhere else. Pick somewhere else while I say this. There are going to be some of you who think that I'm making this up or exaggerating, but I bought this fucking album because I love Paul McCartney and Brian Eno's rad as fuck, and I was getting into techno, and I listened enough, and I was young enough that I was like, well, it seems like some of these are similar. Smash cut to 72 hours ago.
That you think?
I'm fucking my wife.
Wow.
We are actually...
We're in it. You're going dick deep. You're really getting in. Yeah. Big thrusts.
We are mid
hip flexors.
We are enjoying.
Bah. Bah. That's how the captain does it, at least. I don't know how you do it. You might do it faster. Bah, 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 bah. Holy shit. I bet you do, you cheeky son of a bitch. You're going fucking at it like a jackhammer. Trying to fucking wear the paint off, huh? I'll bet you fucking know how to do it. You're getting it down. Anyway, you're fucking, and what are you thinking about?
Well, it's one of those brief windows. I was on the road. I got to get home, and we carved out a whole night to spend together.
Yep.
I heard a phrase I've never heard in my entire life, mid-coitus.
Yeah.
And it was...
Blow it in my eye. Was that it? Sorry, that might be my... That's what I heard 2 nights ago. My name is Captain Morgan. I'm a real character. I lived a life and many lives. I'm an eternal spirit. Brian, go ahead.
In 25 years of being in love with my...
Let's get a big round of applause for 25 years.
I have never, ever heard these words mid-coitus.
Uh-huh.
I'm sorry, Brian. You're going to have to just stop that.
What?
What was that?
What was that?
That was her unable to listen to any more of... what was it again, Bryce?
Oh, Strawberries, Oceans, Ships, Forest.
Actually, I wanted the music, but that's fine. Oh. Yes.
Put it up. Put it up, Bryce. Put it up. Now, whenever you hear this song, no, pump it loud.
I know, but I have to turn it down so you can talk.
No, yeah. No, just think of Brian pumping. Oh, yeah. My name is Brian Brushwood, and I'm fucking my wife. I'm thinking about the Modern Rogue shoot. What are my commercials going to be? Will it be a company that sells you paper clips on a monthly basis?
Only four and a half minutes of this.
Only another one. Wait a minute. No, sorry. Hold on. I'm Brian Brushman. I'm fucking my wife. Step back. I'm really into this. Anyway, what happens? Is there a new bartender in Backspin? I'm trying to edge. I'm trying to edge. This sex is too hot. I'm trying to edge.
Bryce, new track. It'll be different.
Oh, yeah.
It's fine.
No, hold on. Wait a minute. Boop. I'm changing the track. Oh, yeah. I'm Brian Brushwood. Really hitting it. I'm hitting it hard. Uh-oh. It's getting too hot. Let me think of some things that are not hot. Like,
what?
The wire at Oak Hill gonna be after the construction?
Too real.
Is it gonna be? Right.
You crossed the line, Captain Morgan.
You don't mess with our roads.
May not have been an actual thing that happened.
Close your eyes and think of Mopac, huh?
Anyway, I give the universe this book test for free. It is my gift to everyone. Thank you, Paul McCartney. Thank you, Brian Eno. Thank you, this bottle of rum I found.
Mahoy! Brian, there's not going to be a game tonight.
Wait, why?
Because we're having too much goddamn fun.
Yeah,
it's been a long time since me and you just had some fun together.
You know what?
Why don't you ever invite me over on your brain anymore?
Well, it's a bit that I always know, no matter
patreon.com/greatnight is where everybody can go so they can get a bonus episode of this show.
No, not at all. It's that I always know that there's like some dirty bottle of rum in a gutter somewhere, and that's where.
Whoa. And you say that of me?
No.
Like I'm not here trying to promote the fact that at patreon.com/greatnight, you can get a bonus episode of this show no matter what happens every single Thursday. You get it. Nobody else gets it. All the plebs that don't pay for shit, they get half of it. That's what I give broads who don't deserve the captain. Give them half.
By the way,
that's all they get. Dip it once, and then I say, merp, declined, and then I do a backflip out the door. Because I'm limber, Brian. I've got a lot of loose joints. That's what the captain does. I'm disrespectful sexually to those that don't please me. And I have the agility of a gymnast. And that's what happens to all the plebs who don't pay for patreon.com/greatnight. For everybody who does, when they do, oh boy, full pleasure. The whole nine. They get the whole podcast each and every Thursday.
Yep. By the way, this is all very generous of you, Captain Morgan.
Well, I'm here for you.
Given your standing beef with the human, Justin Robert Young.
I don't care about him. I think he's fake. I'm on Conspiracy Commons Reddit, and I've heard that there's a lot of Justin is fake. He's CGI. That's why he's painted blue. Because he's impervious to the direct energy weapons.
Now, Captain Morgan, you know I don't believe in you, and you know I think you're a bottle of rum.
No, but I'm not a bottle of rum.
But I didn't notice that Justin Robert Young is not painted blue.
As you know, you believe the lamestream media tells you a bunch of bull.
Oh my God,
bunch of bull. He's painted blue, Brian. Justin Robert Young has been blue the entire time. Yeah. You didn't notice? You didn't notice that he would randomly start playing drums with paint in it? He's been blue the whole time.
Pause. Can I just say that the greatest magic trick we could ever do is go back and replace everything that has ever happened over the last 15 years and
put
make
Justin Robert Young
blue.
Painted blue.
Yes,
yeah.
Yes, yeah.
And then try to hit him with a laser. See what happens. I saw that video on Conspiracy Commons.
Captain Morgan.
Yes.
You,
yes. Thank God it's back to me.
Wait. As a matter of fact, you're here to plug something, right?
Yep.
Now, you were a little bit coy in our previous conversations.
Well, you know, I'm a coquettish damsel in my heart.
I,
but not in my soul. Two different organs.
I got the vibe that this is a bit of a passion project for you.
Yeah.
Like, you're one of those characters that really presents as a hardened asshole, but secretly is something else.
And I'm just a sensitive artist perpetrating like I am the hardest.
I don't know what that is. You wrote that?
Yep.
As far as I know.
Yep.
Yeah. Okay.
Full credit.
Must
credit Captain Morgan.
Real quick, introduce
Captain
your latest.
Captain Henry James Morgan, a real historical character, not any kind of intellectual property owned by the Usher bottling bitch.
go ahead and pitch your new product.
All right. Sharks, I have a new solution to flying. A lot of people think that to fly, you need to be born a bird or a butterfly or another thing with wings. Well, sharks, I'm here to tell you that that's not the case. This is not your father's flying. No, this is called finger rockets. With only 10 finger rockets that you can get, one a month for only $70,000, you can fly by pointing your hands to the ground. I'll know what you're thinking. If I point my hands in the other way, will both of my finger rockets crush my sternum? The answer is yes. But don't be a dick. We're seeking $4 billion for 5 degrees of separation.
All right, we go to our celebrity panel right now. First celebrity guest, Mr. Robert Downey Jr. Hey, is it just me or are you just describing an Iron Man suit?
No.
Okay.
Nailed it.
Got it in one.
We go next to our resurrected celebrity host, Werner Von Braun.
Oh, yeah. Hello.
Yas?
Oh. No, Werner's over there.
Oh, great.
Yeah, Werner's got his glasses on.
Sorry,
yeah.
It was my ankle.
That's an established bit we do where the host
Yeah,
hello. My money. What?
Hey, what's up, Werner?
Hi.
Hey, you still talking to your old friends, you dipshit? Okay, yeah. Pass me too. We all cover our tracks.
I think I'm gonna
anyway,
be out.
Go ahead.
I think I'm gonna be out. I think I'm out.
Oh, look at the old
It appears like we're on the edge. So we go to our final, third celebrity guest. Lady Gaga.
Well, here I am in my weird dress, and I...
I loved you in the movie, by the way.
Yes.
I thought you were great in the movie.
Yes.
Yeah. I thought you were fantastic. You and the guy.
Bradley.
No, I saw Joker 2. I'm really plugged in.
Go ahead. That was a good dunk.
I think I'll follow Werner on that. Oh, Werner!
Oh, yeah. Oh, you want to be out? We got the scroop waffle.
I'm so sorry, Captain Morgan.
No, so no
Nobody
one's going to give me money.
Your finger rockets that will crush you. That are obviously a rip off of Iron Man. What a bummer. What a bummer. However, we do have this wonderful book test that we would like to give to you, courtesy of Paul McCartney and Brian Eno.
Well, all right. If I could just say a few words.
You know what you
blood can. Blood diamonds are a real problem. And if we don't stop the harvesting of blood diamonds in Africa, then we're real gonna have a lot of bloody diamonds around. So don't hey, is your old pal Captain Morgan saying knock it off? If you don't, I'm coming around. I want to spank your bottom. Anyway, that's my time, y'all. Bye.
Yeah, turn the music up, yo. We love you guys. What did we learn today, Brett?
Well, we learned that Captain Morgan is the most supportive of co-hosts, unlike that other piece of shit, Justin Robert.
What a cock!
We've learned that Cyclops is the most unappreciated animal. And we've learned from one Captain Morgan to another, I salute you.
Captain Morgan.
Yeah, Brian.
It has been an honor and a privilege for you to join me for what I think we can all agree is a very special episode of Great Night.
Me too, Brian. And I'm here to say to you, I look at your face and I see a lot of curves. I want to put my fingers on all of them. I love you a lot. And I want to let you know.
So you're just a bottle of rum.
I'm not a bottle of rum. Shine on, you crazy diamond. It's been a great night, you dumb cunt.
Diamond Club hopes you have enjoyed this program.